Hey everyone, Ripley with Bob's Watches, and welcome to a very special episode of Unboxing. Now, right after we filmed the normal episode, we realized that this one was going to come out right on the same day that the upcoming James Bond film, No Time to Die, was, and since the film is going to be out on the same day this is out, we have something really special to share with you guys. So, as you can see from this bag, and this card in it, from Omega, join us for the screening of the latest 007 movie. Now, we love our viewers, and obviously anything that we get access to, we want to share with you. So we wanted to pop this open, and inside this bag, we've got something that we think you're going to enjoy. Now, not everyone gets to see this. This isn't something you get if you buy the watch. This isn't something you get if you attend the movie. And it's inside this box direct from Omega. Now, again, no one's seen this. You get exclusive access. And what is it? It is a keychain. A tiny keychain inspired by the titanium mesh bracelet on the upcoming that will be worn by Daniel Craig in the upcoming film No Time to Die. Just like the one worn in the film, this is made out of titanium mesh. It holds your keys, and if you're lucky enough to have one of these things, now your key ring will match your Seamaster. So before we give anything more away and start talking about all of the secrets that'll be in the upcoming James Bond film No Time to Die, sit with us and watch this episode of Unboxing. Here at Bob's Watches, we receive thousands of timepieces from all over the world, each one with their own story and unique personality. But one thing's always certain, we never know what exactly will be in the box. So, we have here a pretty big box. I feel like almost anything could be inside. We've been getting a lot of these in. It's not too heavy either, so I mean, that doesn't help me much at all, but... as always, the obligatory bubble wrap, and here we go. Oh, small box, and it looks like an Omega. I think I know which one this one is, just because I've seen this box before, but let's just see if I'm right. I don't want to spoil the surprise. Yep, there we go. What this is the all-new Omega Seamaster Diver 300 meters. That is coming out for the James Bond film, No Time to Die. Now, this is the one that's going to be coming out this, I guess it'd be this Friday, coming soon, on the 8th of October. And this is the watch that Daniel Craig will actually be wearing in the film. Also, fun fact, he is a watch enthusiast and he helped design it. Now, before we get into the watch itself, first things first, you'll notice this is a... given the normal Omega packaging, this is about as minimalist it gets. You get this nice leather travel pouch, which has room for the watch and a spring bar tool, and if you had another strap, and then you've got, you know, your warranty card and your booklet in this rather small box. But considering the previous Moonwatch shipped in a briefcase, and then there's that other Seamaster, the Spectre, I think it was, that has a whole combination lock on the box, this is a really small and rather minimalist package. So I guess, what is the watch itself? Although Craig has, you know, most frequently worn Planet Oceans and, you know, a couple Aquaterras and Divers throughout his tenure as Bond, most people, when they think of a James Bond Omega, think of some version of the Diver 300 meters. This is the one that Pierce Brosnan wore during the 90s when he Omega and the James Bond franchise first started. And for a lot of people, this is just the classic James Bond Omega silhouette. Like the standard Omega Seamaster Diver from this generation, 42 millimeters, you know, winding crown here, rotating timing bezel, and your manually operated helium escape valve. Now, the two big differences with this one are, one, you'll notice there's no date display at all on the 6 o'clock right there. Similar to what Pierce Brosnan first wore in the original James Bond films in the 1990s when Omega first became the official watch of James Bond, has a much more dressy silhouette than the Planet Ocean, not nearly as thick. Both professional dive watches with rotating timing bezels, screw down crowns, and manual operated helium escape valves, but it is a rather different watch. Now, what's different about this particular version, the No Time to Die edition, compared to your regular standard Seamaster Diver 300 meters? Well, both models feature 42 millimeter case, both have a rotating timing bezel, but where they differ starts now with the movement. If you notice at the 6 o'clock, this one doesn't have a date display, it's a time only affair, and that's a bit different. The standard one has a date display, and on top of that, this whole thing, bracelet included, is made out of grade 2 titanium rather than stainless steel like the normal version. What that means is it's very lightweight and also very corrosion resistant, super tough material, but the differences don't start there. If you look over on the side profile here, you can tell the crystal is quite a bit more domed and sticks up a bit further than the normal Seamaster. What this is intended to emulate kind of the vintage acrylic crystals and their pronounced dome. Obviously, this one's made out of synthetic sapphire, but what it is meant to do along with the age loom is evoke more of a kind of vintage inspired retro aesthetic. That continues onto the material of the dial and the bezel itself. Now, on the standard models, the steel ones, it's made out of ceramic. On this one, it's made of specially treated aluminum, both the dial and the bezel. It's kind of this matte, dark brown gray kind of color, and the intent of it is it's supposed to look vintage, and it's also supposed to fade and age over time. So over the years, these watches are going to age a bit differently and kind of play into that whole patina thing. Not only is it the dial and hands that are luminous, but the bezel insert markings are also luminous on this version. That's different than the normal one. They're normally white lacquer. So this, you know, you get that added functionality in the dark. Now flipping the watch over, you get what is again one of the biggest significant or most significant differences compared to the standard model, and that is a closed case back. On the normal version, what you get is a clear case back, lets you see the movement, beautiful movement, I'm always happy to see it. But on this one, having a closed case back is a bit more accurate for what, you know, they might be issuing to their to MI6 agents. Now, interesting thing about this, you'll notice the broad arrow insignia up at the top, and that's also on the dial. Now, interesting thing about this symbol, it's used to signify that this object is property of Britain's government. You see it on issued watches that are issued to members of the military. Now, this is not property of British government at all, but Omega did have to get permission to use the symbol. So that's what that one means. Moving down forward, these are the real markings, so these do are the same MOD markings as you would find on an actual issued watch, despite the fact that this it was never issued. Think of it as a prop and an accurate one at that. So that first series of digits before the slash, the 0552, that denotes that it's of a Navy personnel, as Bond was a Navy commander. That's very accurate for him. The second series, that 9237897, that signifies it's a diver's watch, as this is a dive watch. That also makes sense. The A, in reference to the fact that the crown screws down. Yep, present and correct. And then the 007, that should be self-explanatory. That's for James Bond. And 1962, that 6-2 is a reference to 1962, which is when Dr. No, the very first James Bond film, came out. Beyond that, what you have is the 007 marking, the water resistance rating, which is 300 meters, like the standard diver 300. And what you see here is the NIAID lock symbol. What this is it's Omega's style of proprietary case back closure. It doesn't screw on like a regular watch. And what this allows Omega to do is it's a very complex system, but enables them to line up the engravings every time. So after, should you have it open during service, when it gets back together, it's going to look just like this with the engravings all nicely lined up. I think a lot of the appeal of this watch has to do with the bracelet. Omega does sell it on a striped NATO strap. Retail price is $8,100 for the NATO and $9,200 for the titanium mesh. And the titanium mesh, this is one of the best mesh bracelets I think I've ever had the option or the opportunity to mess around with. It's got this really lovely kind of hole base closure system, so you don't have to cut the links or anything. It locks into place, of course. And then the attention to detail, even on the end, I don't know if you can see it here, the very, very tip of it, it is even engraved with the Omega logo. And of course, it being flexible and lightweight titanium, it's super comfy. And I don't even mind that they have these gaps here between the watch and where the bracelet starts. I think it kind of plays into the whole vintage aesthetic. So, what this watch is going to do in the movie, I don't know yet because I haven't seen the movie. We're filming this just ahead of when No Time to Die comes out in the United States. So until this Friday, I don't know what it does. I've heard some rumors, but I don't want to spoil it for myself. But I do know that whatever it is, it does have some gadget in it. I hope it involves the helium escape valve because you aren't likely to use it in real life. It'd be nice if someone got some use out of it, whether it's to detonate a bomb or shoot a grappling hook or whatever it has done in the past with the Brosnan films. So there you have it. Full thing grade 2 brushed titanium on a matching titanium bracelet. A lot of people are saying this is one of the best, if not the best, James Bond Omega watches ever. This is going to be identical to the model worn by Daniel Craig in the film No Time to Die, probably without the special spy gadgets, although, you know, maybe if we turn enough knobs and rotate the bezel the right way, something will happen. But I'm really looking forward to see how exactly he's going to use this in the film. And I'm also excited to see if some of these features, such as the more domed crystal, the solid case back, the no date movement, are going to work their way into some of the standard production models too. Well, until I see the movie, that's all speculation, and until they come out with the next series of Omega Seamaster Diver 300 meter watches, also speculation, but until then, this is easily one of my favorite Omega Seamaster models currently in production. And given that you don't also have to keep an enormous box along with it, you just have this highly practical travel roll, that all seems the better. All in all, this is one of my favorite Omega Seamaster watches, and certainly one of my favorite James Bond Omega Seamaster watches. As always, don't forget to tune in next time for our next unboxing video series, where we pull aside one box, open it up on camera, and let's see what's in it. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can stay up to date on our latest video content.